is Small Trees. Small Trees of Pink and Purple. The magenta all by itself. I love brushes that kind of get broken up a little bit and leave you broken pieces, as opposed to a really, really nice brush that gives you a solid, hard line. You need both, but at some point, just doing suggestions of to block it in. So I put it in wet into wet, get it started, get it suggested, come back and noodle it and put harder edges in later on. So this whole painting went in wet into wet, and we had lots of soft edges. The subject matter is now going in with soft edges just to get it established and what's important. And then we said, hey, I really need one here in the foreground coming in. So, okay, there's going to be some bigger chunks. We're eventually going to have some of those guys in shadow. So, yes, there are going to be some darker purples. And I'm going to work down here on these guys here in a second. So you're going to block them in for the most part just to get the shape. Just like the clouds, you kind of block them in, get the general shape, the lights and the darks. You come back in on the second layer and do all of the detail work that really describes each of the separate subject matters. So in every painting, it doesn't matter. Block it in kind of wet into wet, get the soft out of focus stuff established, and then you can come in and put all of your really hard edged look at me kind of stuff in the foreground over the top of it. Change and have a variety. Do not make it all the exact same magenta. I know they're the exact same magenta, but we don't really need to see that. We need to see the fact that some of them are in shadow, some of them are dried out, some of them are being hit by sunlight and a little bit warmer than others. And then once again, if you find your pieces kind of medium on medium, get in here and say, well, I know that I had a darker, there were lots of dark values down here supporting my, all right. It takes a dark sometimes to make a light pop out. I'm gonna go a little bit darker just to get the extreme value going on here. So boy, does your eye go here. Darkest value change, the most amount of activity. I don't want to be doing this all the way back over in there then if I want your eye to stay here. The value change is really important for your subject matter. So if your clouds are not a light on a dark, they're not going to look tremendous. If they're just a light on a medium, it's like, okay, kind of a light on a medium, it's okay. Maybe the storyline is not the clouds. We're going to have something else that's more intense. So generally speaking, you can block things in fairly quick and fast. Some dark ones in here for the heck of it. And then come in. So this is kind of like the underwear stage. Then we got the dressing and we're putting in the peppy outfits. And then we put the jewelry on, the last bit. We don't put the jewelry on before we put our underwear on. So the jewelry is fine when you kind of come in and do all of the stuff that says, wow, extreme darks or extreme lights. The little jewelry pieces that make your painting say what the story is truly about and where you want the eye to go. So three layers minimum is kind of the average on most of my paintings. Five in reality by the time I'm paying attention and changing my mind. But for the most part, that's kind of the process. So whether it's trees or flowers or something else in the foreground, it's going to be darker than what's in the background. The background's neutral, soft white, soft grays. As it gets closer to you, it has more value, and then as it gets even closer to you, it's even more value, even darker. So at this point, over those darks, I might have some other light things to add interest as well. So darks on lights on darks are important in a painting. Okie dokie. So as I come around and help you finish off